Hello, Mumtase, and welcome back to the chat with Dolphin. Please do subscribe, like, definitely share this video only if I am your favorite cup of tea. So, guys, I know it's been a minute, right? But anyways, I had to cool off a little bit. So, please give me my flowers because what I said about Gogo Maweni has finally come to the light. But anyways, without further ado, please kindly watch this video, guys, and I'll come back with my commentary afterwards.
I'm a man of
Okay.
You understand?
Just Examol Kupula, Kirikal Kupula leads. Hey, Nanon Kobelogo, Udo, Nantuki Kupulang, and Donogas Kupuli, Rizzi, Honsamazuza Dame, Guntum Zabatu, Samasangoma Hole, Pelabon Kumbulam Muleban Albo, 102, 103, 107, one among my old lady legend, Halibal thing, it jumped up a John legend.
6 months. This is 6 months.
Yes.
I can't. This is 6 months.
Okay, Bumtase, there you have it from, you know, someone who claims to expose the Gogo Maweni situation. And apparently this is how Gogo Maweni responded by saying, and if you are the biggest fan of Gogo Maweni, you will know Uguti. This is definitely unlike Gogo Maweni, and which means Uguti, something is brewing over here. But anyways, we are going to come back to this comment after I give you my whole commentary during, I mean, throughout the whole situation that it transpired. So guys, I would like to take you back from the video that you just saw on that podcast, right? As you can see, those people are wearing the same t-shirts. I mean, like, those t-shirts are branded the same way, let me just put it that way, because the colors are different, black and white. So, but the name that is written on those t-shirts is called Sjugu, and apparently Sjugu is the same guy who is busy exposing Gogo Maweni, right? So guys, I assume from my perspective, I assume ore, this was the, I mean, this is the new podcast, and it needed to trend. And what better way can you make something tangible, something that can trend, than use the name that is gonna work for you, the name that is now a brand, you know? So that's why he had to make that podcast all about Gogo Maweni. And honestly, it worked for him. It worked for him because now he was trending. And you know what? It really worked for him. And for that, I give him 10 for his marketing strategy, which we cannot even blame him for that, because it is what Gogo Maweni did to get where she is as we speak. So guys, let's get to the point where he was busy exposing Gogo Maweni. I think a lot of things that he exposed they were not new, that he that Gogo Maweni bewitched her baby daddy, blah 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 blah. What got me intrigued was when he said that Gogo Maweni actually paid him to act and pretend as if he was one of his, I mean, he initiates. I mean, like, what kind of a person will do something or will stoop so low for people to love him or to trend? Like, yo, for someone to pretend as if maybe he is a Sangoma, even though he's not a Sangoma. And for that, Gogo Maweni, I'm so disappointed in you. Although, I'm not surprised. The reason why I'm not surprised, I've been saying this all along, that many celebrities, many Sangomas, the reason why now they are acting as if they are holier or maybe they are witches is because they want to be relevant and they want to trend. I get it now, then you feel like, okay, fine. Then what if maybe, yeah, my goal is I have to lie to get where I want to be. And this is what they do. They always do everything. Even these shows that are playing on Moja Love, guys, they are scripted because they will do everything to trend. So what the guy was basically saying is that, okay, fine, I was so desperate, and one thing about me, I'm a great actor and I will do everything for money. So since I will do everything for fucking money, I allowed Gogo Maweni to buy me, you know. So for me to act as if I was one of her initiates and Kinali Itlozi, it was just a game to me, because I will do everything for money. What kind of a man will stoop so low to pretend as if only Itlozi, even though he doesn't have Itlozi? I mean, like, that's my question. What kind of a person does that? What kind of a man does that? So hence I'm saying, like, Mugai and Miguel, they're the same. And so for me, I feel like, okay, you exposed to Gogo Maweni, but okay, Mdase, why now? Why now? Because this guys, Sangoma Zodumo, like, played or aired on our national TV long time ago, and now you just come here and you tell us or Gogo Maweni actually bought you and you were pretending. Okay, what can we do about the situation? Because it is done, it's done. Gogo Maweni got her fame, you know, she got the fame. So the question that I'm asking myself right now, okay, fine, since when or when you don't have Itlozi, we're pretending. Does Gogo Maweni have Itlozi? Is Gogo Maweni the real Sangoma? Because if she managed to buy someone to pretend as if they had this gift, what if Lena earned the gift? I'm just saying, what if? So anyways, guys, yeah, man, all I was saying was that the likes of Gogo Maweni and Gogo Skhotheni know how to trend, and they know how to trend. And the only way to trend is if you do something stupid, if you talk about witchcraft. And if you take that note, remember, Gogo Maweni is the only woman who owned up on this witchcraft thing. You know, she owned up being a witch. She stood up, and that's how she got this love that she's receiving. Maybe because people are the biggest fan of Tagats. We'll never know. But anyways, guys, like I said, she took a gamble and She rolled with it and it worked for her. And we're not gonna blame her. We are not even gonna blame him for making Gogo Maweni trending. I mean trend. Because at the end of the day, it's business. I honestly feel sorry for her initiates. Because they have to go through such things. Maybe she's teaching them how to pretend, you know, to have it close even though you don't have it close. Honestly, guys, this is so sad. But anyways, yeah, I had to say this. The guy only wanted to market his new channel, and he wanted to showcase his channel, I mean his podcast. And yeah, I mean, good work, you trended, and maybe you got subscribers from the video that you just made about Gogo Maweni. All you wanted was to be relevant, and we cannot even blame you for trying to be relevant. And also, Gogo Maweni did what she had to do to get where she is right now. Now, Gogo Maweni, you are a celebrity, you know how to, yeah, tell us nonsense, you know how to insult us like nobody's business. So, yeah, hence I'm saying, good see, they both got what they wanted, and I don't blame them, because guys, one thing that you should understand is that everyone wants fame. Many people want fame, and they will go extra length to get that fame. And that's it from me at the chat with Dolphin. I hope you enjoyed it. Bye.